Welcome back, everybody, to A&M Reviews. It's Muhammad and Adrian. The movie that we're going to talk about today is called The Tax Collector. This movie is essentially about these two guys, Bobby Soto and Shia LaBeouf. They are the tax collectors who goes around and collect the money from each of the gangs around their area, because everybody who runs a gang, they need to pay up. But what did you get from The Tax Collector?
I didn't read anything or see anything before watching the film. So if I had to guess based on the title, I thought, you know, maybe The Tax Collector would be something like The Accountant. And I wasn't totally off. I love The Accountant. Wait, what?
No, this is not The Accountant.
It's pretty good, though. It's action. I mean, you pretty much got the tax collectors. It's pretty much a metaphor for what they do. They pretty much tax every gang in the area they don't run with. So they're like, you know, if you're going to be on our turf, you're going to be selling drugs, you're going to be doing this and that, you're going to pay us taxes, or we'll come for you, everybody you love. That's their whole shtick. And Bobby's father is in jail, still running the entire organization. And Bobby's kind of like the man on the ground from the beginning. I thought it was pretty well executed. I like Shia LaBeouf's character, Creeper. He's kind of like the messed up hired hands whose only job is to kill and defend and protect. So I thought it was pretty good. Some of the reviews weren't as nice, but I think it was interesting. There was a lot of like I like the fact that it wasn't just like cops versus this gang. Like, not that I'm rooting for the bad guy, but I like the fact that we had a redemption story in this bad guy's circle arc. And one of the things I thought about while I was watching the most was how religious Bobby is. He's Catholic, always praying. The kids look like they're in a Catholic private school. So he's very religious, but a merciless murderer. And I guess he justifies it because he's doing what he has to do for the family. But I mean, how many times can he ask forgiveness when you're doing this stuff on purpose? So it's interesting juxtaposition that he puts himself in all the way through till the end.
Yeah, I agree. There's multiple conflicting things with this character, Bobby Soto. Like you were saying, he's very religious, but he runs around with this gang, or more like Shia LaBeouf, and he supposedly kills people. I mean, they do, but I also feel like they never actually go as far as what they say, because they do a lot of kind of teasing you, like, okay, this guy is so terrible, you know, he's killed this many people, he has no heart, he'll kill anybody. But they don't really show it that much. We see some of it when it comes to them trying to run from a certain person later on, but they're not as ruthless as they say.
They're pretty forgiving.
They're still bad guys, though.
Right, still bad guys, but redeeming qualities. So, like, I mean, you had Bobby went to this guy's place. He's like, you shorted us on the taxes. What's going on? He's like, my daughter has leukemia. I'm sorry. I was holding the money. Creeper was ready to shoot him, ready to kill him and his wife. But Bobby was like, no, we'll hold off. So he's kind of like a nice guy. He has a bit of a conscience when compared to some of his other family members and how they do things, which is, it was interesting to watch.
Okay, so let's go ahead and rate it. So the lowest rating is trash, middle is background noise, and the highest is a banger. So how'd you rate the film, The Tax Collector?
I would rate this as high background noise. That's a little high for the amount of hate this movie has gotten. But I think it's a good film. You don't really necessarily have to know the story to still get a little invested, see some action all the way to the end. But I enjoyed it.
Okay. I enjoyed it in parts, but this is nothing special. It's very generic. So this is a low background noise.
Okay.
I mean, there's not much to really take from this. I mean, what lessons can you learn from this movie?
Well, there's nothing to be learned.
don't get in the drug game. But yeah, I mean, pretty generic. Thanks for watching. And if you would like to be featured on our podcast, make sure to click the link in the description.